Next question is from Cassidy Hoffman Official. Do you think that gluttony is a fair criticism of Christianity? Have you seen clients or others use faith to battle gluttony?
Wow. Hey, Cassidy's official now. That's good news.
Yeah, I'll go with the second part first, which is, have you seen clients or others use faith to battle gluttony? Okay, so when you look at studies on diets or particular ways of eating, what you find is a very high failure rate. I think it's something like 80-something percent of people who go on a diet totally fail, even if their intentions are good. I want to lose weight. I want to improve my health. It often is those kinds of intentions, and they fail very high. However, when people embark on a diet for moral or spiritual or faith-based reasons, okay, the success rate is very high. So let's talk about, let's step out of Christianity for a second. I'll address that, but let's step out there for a second. Let's look at vegans. Vegans who become vegans because they're trying to improve their health, high failure rate. Vegans who become vegans because they believe it's moral to not eat animals, very high success rate. You look at the Seventh-day Adventists. This is a offset kind of Christian group that eats in a particular way based off their faith. Or look at
Mormons. Mormons don't have soda. They don't have, a lot of things.
Right. They're very, very good with it. Why? Because they're eating in a way that goes beyond themselves. This is the mental aspect of it, right? I'm not just doing this for me. I'm doing this for this moral reason that's bigger than myself, whether it be for the benefit of animals or maybe it be a God. My God, this is why I eat this way, because God tells me to, or because my body's a temple. God says, take care of my temple. Whatever it is, faith behind or moral reasons behind your choices, just from a psychological standpoint, is one of the most powerful ways people can make changes in their life. And look at the 12 steps to quitting drugs and alcohol. It's based on religion. I think I believe it's a Christian application, and it has one of the higher success rates because of that morality that goes behind it. Now, to the first part, do I think gluttony is a fair criticism of Christianity? I was an atheist for a long time, and one of my biggest criticisms of all religion was how imperfect people who followed religions were.
The hypocrisy.
Mm-hmm. I would walk into a church. My family was Catholic, so even though I was atheist, I'd go to family events and stuff, and I'd sit in there just looking around. Look at that person. They're over here, doing their thing, and I know that person, and they're so not perfect. And that person's so not perfect. That person's so not perfect. Mm-hmm. And once I flipped that on myself, it's like going to the gym. Imagine going to the gym, looking at all these people working out, and then saying to yourself, look at all these fat people. They don't really believe in what they're doing. I know they eat bad. They're in here working.
Well, they're trying.
The reality is, there ain't a single perfect person in this world. Everybody struggles with everything. And gluttony, as defined in Christianity, essentially is eating a lot of food or being greedy at the detriment of somebody who's needy. In other words, I'm eating so much food and I'm just stuffing myself, even though there's people around me that need food. That's kind of the definition of gluttony. Well, you know what? Look in the mirror. If you have more than one pair of shoes, one pair of pants, a shirt, if you have a roof, you are, I guess I could call you that kind of a person as well, right? Because there's so many people that could need those things. Nobody's perfect, so.
Yeah, I mean, this is an interesting question because, I did grow up a lot in the culture of church, and I had my own fair share of criticisms about just the culture in general, just by observing a lot and being in the back and not feeling like I was ever in the community. I was in the community, I was out of the community because there was a lot of the judgmental stuff that came, but it was hypocritical in some of these aspects, like even this one being mentioned. There was not a lot of emphasis on health practices and having healthy, practices involved and wrapped into all these other parts of faith-based practices. And so I was always curious about why that wasn't highlighted, as strongly as all these other values that they're promoting within church. But again, it was just a reflection of the culture where I was. So if I was in the Midwest and I'm, in a church there where it was very much like the culture that I was around was into potlucking and into all these, like they showed love by providing food for everybody. And so this became like part of the thing where it was like, we all come here, we eat and we share and it's a way that they show love. And so it's, it again, it's from an outside perspective, you could pick apart like sort of any organization that you could find holes in something that I feel like you know, like you're going to find that in any organization that you're going to look into that deeply.
Well, the Bible addresses your points in Matthew 7:5, right? It's the pull the plank out of your own eye before you pull the sliver out of somebody else's.
Right.
So it addresses that exact thing. And I think I struggled with this too, being a fitness professional in like my early 20s, like seeing the same thing and the hypocrisy. I was still in my 20s going through a lot of anger, animosity towards my family and how I was raised. And so I had a lot of bitterness I was dealing with, and I judged the same way. I looked at these people and thought, oh, they talk about all these other things that they're trying to focus on and be good, and yet here they are poisoning their body, and that's considered one of the seven deadly sins, and yada, yada, yada. I also think that we are in the middle of a kind of shift, because there is that starting to happen now. Like, I don't know how familiar you guys are with churches and Christianity and other religions too are starting to follow suit. This is relatively new when you compare to religion. 100 years ago, religions weren't having to speak to gluttony very much. There was a scarcity of food.
That's true.
Not a lot of people were abusing this. That's so true. In our lifetime, we have seen a major shift. I mean, processed foods have really hit the scene just in the last 20 to 30 years. This hasn't been something very long that people have been, obesity is like skyrocketed just recently.
That's a great point.
When you compare it to religion that's been taught for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years, this is a new battle, and you are seeing some churches and some religions starting to address it. And I just don't think they ever had to.
Not to mention the misinformation they're getting from the standards, for nutrition given from the government. It's like, where do you get the information that's all? Like, the general public wasn't even receiving it.
So. Well, I'll say this, okay? Greed has always been with people. It's always been a problem. Doesn't matter how much or little you have or what system of government you have, whatever. Greedy people exist. Greed is it's something that we all need to contend with. All of us suffer from some degree of it, of course, especially if you live in this country. I can very easily make the case that you're greedy comparing you to somebody else somewhere else in the world. Now, the religions, here's the deal, okay? Fitness has been something I've been studying for a long time. Religion, I've learned it mainly because I started out as an atheist. Now it's a little different. And here's what I found that was very interesting. In all the major religions, they all talk about greed, and fasting in some way, shape, or form is embedded in every single religion. Fasting was a way for these religions to teach people or themselves how to be without.
Yeah, how to abstain.
How to detach, how to abstain. So they have been having some of these conversations about gluttony and greed. That's been around for a very long time. But Adam makes an excellent point. We haven't had, like, obesity really hasn't been an issue. If you look at the whole history of the church, thousands of years, it's the last, 50 that we're dealing with, with obesity.
It's relatively new.
Yeah. So I think it's fair to criticize anybody's practice, so long as you do it objectively with reason. But I don't think it's fair to isolate it or to one specific practice. I don't think it's a Christian thing or a Judaism thing or Islamic thing or Buddhist thing. It's a human thing. We deal with it all the time. It is a part of human nature to take more than you need and to overindulge. It's not just with food. It happens with technology. It happens with sex. It happens with drugs. It happens with money. It happens with attention from other people. It's just a human trait that we're always going to need to contend with. And I do think it's important that you become aware of it, because happiness, that I'm starting to learn now as I get older, is on the other side of that. Happiness comes from detachment, not from attachment.